The image generator we will be using is called Fooocus. Fooocus is an AI image generator that is very easy to set up, is based on stable diffusion, and it is also completely free to use. This Google Colab notebook is a diffusion web UI called Fooocus, and this is a diffusion GNU design, and the best thing, you can even install this on your local computer. This is open source and free to use, but in this video, we're going to use its Google Colab notebook that is a cloud-based, and if you're a mobile user, simply go to your Chrome browser and turn on the desktop mode. And now you can do the same thing on your mobile phone. So first of all, simply click on this connect button, and this will be connected to your GPU. Don't worry, this is all cloud-based, you don't need any GPU for that. So once it's connected, simply click on this play button and click run anyway. Now this will start executing the code, and you only have to wait for a few minutes, okay? So once it's done, you just have to click on this grade, your link, and you will be redirected to its web interface. So here you guys can see we have the space to enter the prompt, we have the input image options, we have the advanced options. So first of all, click on this advanced option. And now you can see we have few options here. You can select the aspect ratio, we have each and every aspect ratio that you can imagine, and you can even control the number of images here. Then you can enter the next negative prompt in it, if you want to, but we're going to leave it like this, and from here, you can even control the quality of your image. But I would like to keep it default. The next option is the style option. And here you can see we have different styles, and the by default, this is selected as a Fooocus version to Fooocus. Enhance Fooocus. There is a complete list of styles that you can select from the food, anime, realistic ads, watercolor, typography, cyberpunk, futuristic, photographic, and this is the endless list of styles that you can select. But we're only going to go with the Fooocus version 2, Fooocus Enhance and Fooocus Shop, that is the default setting now. Next we have the models, and here you can see we have the base model Juggernaut XELN. According to me, this is the most realistic model in stable diffusion, so don't change anything in it, just keep it like a default. Then we have the advanced option, where you can select the guidance skills and even the image sharpening, but I would recommend you to use the default settings. Now select the aspect ratio, in what aspect ratio you want to make an image. So I'm going to select the 1:1. And now in the prompt section, I'm going to use this prompt, realistic portrait of a beautiful woman with purple hair, slightly faded Spanish light freckles, blue eyes, no makeup. Now hit generate, and this will start generating your image. And the image generation time depends on the number of images and the image quality that you have selected. And now you can see it gave us two beautiful images of a girl. So this is the first image, and this is the second image, and look at this, how realistic these images are. Now save the image that you like most. So I'm going to save it on my computer. So once it's downloaded, the next step is to click on this input image option. And now you can see we have few options here, upscale, variation, image prompt, and inpainting or outpainting. But for now, we have to click on this image prompt, and here simply upload the image. Now go to your prompt section and just type anything like female doctor in white coat standing in laboratory, and hit generate, because we give it an image prompt that will try to generate the same model but in different locations. And here we have the output images, and now you can see this is almost matching with our first image. You can see this is the same lady but in different pose and different clothes. Now let's try something else. We're going to focus on inpainting in Fooocus. Select inpaint or outpaint. Which is the default. And then there are options here for improving details for the face and hands and eyes, or modify content, which lets you add objects, change the background, so on. I'm just gonna mask over her hair here, and then prompt, we're gonna put pink and green hair. Go into the advanced tab here, and you'll see a tab here for inpaints. This is where you will find the inpaint denoir strength, so much like automatic one. If you increase the strength, the change will be more drastic. Let's do something a little bit different. I'm going to bring in this image, and this time I'm going to select just your standard inpaint mode. You see that we have different hairstyles. I quite like this one, that one looks cool. So there really is no limits to what you can do with inpainting. Now let's try something else. I'm just gonna mask over her hair here, and then prompt, we're gonna put red and black hair. You see that we have different hairstyles. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful and subscribe to our channel for more amazing tutorials like this one. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, happy creating!